So I'm Jacob, metalcore band from Norway. We've been going for about 10 years, and we have our fourth album coming out in a week. It's called Subway Anthem. You're gonna like it if you. That's what I swear.
Thanks for joining us tonight, mate. Well, as you say, man, ATENA released your new album Subway Anthem on September 29th. So, how are you feeling about it?
I feel great. We spent a lot of time on it, and people have been responding well so far, and that's always a relief. I'm just super proud of what we've done.
Yeah. So, can you tell us a bit more about the album from a musical point of view and what you're going for with it?
I guess it depends a bit on what you've heard of us before, but in general, it's kind of a modern metalcore sound. Which sounds cliche, but there's maybe more cinematic elements. We try to like expand on what we've done before. I could give you all the band cliches of the heaviest being heavier and the melodies being more melodic. There's some of that. There's more. We use more electronics. Gunnar's is really that stuff. We've been using him for that for years. We've always had electronic elements in our sound. We've expanded on that part as well, so we just really feel like we've grown a lot, I guess. Yeah. If this makes sense, if it answers your question.
Yeah, sure. And you've released the singles Poison Pure, Oh My, Hard Day, and Subway Anthem. So just say if that's all someone's heard of the band, would you say that's a good representation of the album?
Well, absolutely, yep. Because you got both the soft songs with Oh My and also like the, I guess the more intricate ones with like Slip Away, which is both heavy and melodic and has like, it's not the most original song structure, but it's not the most common one either. So it gives a good impression of all the different sounds on the album. Yeah.
So we mentioned before, like it's your fourth album as a band. So do you have a set writing and recording process for the album, or does it differ every time?
This one has been a bit different from the three previous ones, in the sense that the three previous ones were concept albums, all coming from the head of main song, Weberen, who plays guitar. And finally, like finishing that trilogy last time has opened up some. Opportunities lyric-wise to edit, which also then inspires different sounds and vice versa. Like, I think for Weberen especially, who always starts these songs off, it was like a breath of fresh air to be able to just think, like, what do I want to make outside of those boundaries kind of set by those concepts? Even though those three albums don't sound exactly the same, it was kind of like a... there were concepts to follow. So there's a difference there. Other than that, for writing, it's been the same as it always has been. Weberen coming up with ideas from inspiration from seeing movies, hearing movie soundtracks, listening to Oasis and Slipknot, and whatever he does. And then just me and him working together, trying to get his ideas out there, and then just building on that, bringing in our friend Jon, who does the electronics, and then bringing it on to drums and bass and etc. Yep.
But your last album, Drowning Regret and Lungs Filled with Water, was an international hit. It's fair to say that it was probably your most successful album. So was it tempting to recycle that formula this time around, or was it more important for you guys to sort of show a bit more musical growth on this one?
I didn't hear the word recycle. The what?
I thought, was it like you could have recycled that same formula, like. Try and done everything.
All right, yeah.
But what was it important for you to try and move beyond that and sort of show that you're capable of more?
I don't know if it was a goal in and of itself, and it's not like we've switched styles completely. Like it's not a death metal record. It's not a Dragon Force album. Like it's clearly related to the one you're talking about, and sounds etc. But I guess it was a bit important to just not think too much about being. Directly related to that one, even though you end up sounding kind of the same, but there are more, I guess, pop sensibilities in terms of song structures to some degree on some songs that I wouldn't say you find on Drowning Regret and the albums before it. So that's kind of a a big difference, but I mean they're not pop songs. It's just that's one of the differences.
Yeah. So on that subject, mate, like you guys have shown a lot of musical growth with every album. So how much growth do you think left in the band?
My internet is spotty, apparently.
So you guys have shown a lot of musical growth over every album. So how much growth do you think's left in the band?
I don't know. I hope there's more. I think there's more. I haven't really thought about it. I've been like Webern always finds a way. Like you can tell we all rely on him and his brain for for moving this stuff along. But he has. We're all really happy that we have him in our lives because he has that kind of artist brain, like actual artist brain, like dropping out of college artist brain, like which makes him like really receptive to inspiration and ways that we others maybe aren't that good at. Like he knows exactly how much to like twist the formula to make it interesting, and that's so we all feel really lucky to like be a part of his universe. Like obviously we all contribute. It's just that's kind of one of the most special things at ATENA for the rest of us. We all come from different bands, right? Like all bands do. But I think that's what makes it unique, which is probably a lot of pressure for him. But it's been going good so far. And in terms of growth, yeah, I'm sure there's going to be more, and especially collaborating with that friend of ours, Yoon, the electronics guy. He's from another city far away. That is always, I think it's an inspiration in itself, because like you send him like a bare bones track, like a demo, tell him kind of what you're looking for, and then you get something back, and those sounds and how amazing those are will like maybe change the direction of what you thought you were going to do as well. So Webern has good ideas, and we've been good at collaborating, and as long as we keep doing that, I think we're going to keep growing.
The press release describes your sound as classic metalcore with a more urban landscape. Like, can you explain what they mean by more urban landscape?
Yeah, it's probably the EDM influence. Yep. Right. It sounds like that to me. Like with Subway Anthem, the song itself, you have that kind of the 90s DNB drum break going on top of the normal drums.
Yep.
I think it's that kind of sound. Maybe it's because we all saw that Bumfunk MC's freestyle video when we were kids on TV. It's probably that.
So overall, like, you've got a mix of heavy guitars, you've got the electronics in there, the samples and the hip-hop influences. So where did the idea to blend all of that together come from? It's a pretty unique mix.
I guess there's one of them is just listening to different things and being able to appreciate different sounds, which a lot of musicians and music fans agree on is important. And then there's also a desire to kind of try to make something unique, I think. And then there's also like completely pragmatic things, like everyday life things that have influenced it. Like when I became the singer, like, what can I do? Get me grabbed so out of the pit, so we have to do something else. And sing, I can do the happy stuff. That also influences like what part of our influences we can use. So desire to stand out, in addition to those things, I think has been important, especially maybe, I don't know, you're trying to, like, we've been a local band almost here for ages, and trying to capture people's, yeah, you have to steal people's time. You have to grab them away from Netflix. You have to grab them away from the other bands who maybe don't sound as interesting to someone who's never heard them before. So there's also like a desire to, I guess, shock people into like making them remember us, and having lots of influences and melding them well is a good strategy, and also makes good songs, of course.
And then, now you mentioned melding them well, mate, which sort of leads me on the next question. Like, How difficult is it to get the balance right in your songs with all those different styles? Like, how do you know you've gone too far with one or you're not far enough with another?
I know Vebjørn does a lot of focus grouping with only himself in the
How
focus
can that
group.
be a group then?
All the different sides of him, I guess. No, but we sent it, he sends it around to us as well, and it's one thing we've been good at, mainly because of him, I must say, is being like really hard on listening to something and is this actually good enough? Can we release it or should we work more on it? Because if it's boring and we can pick up on that, then it's absolutely not worth it. So, serving the song, a cliche for a reason, is a big, like, it's something to measure the parts of the song against. So, okay, if this is boring and it needs another drum beat section or whatever, which none of us play live because like we're not computers, like if it's a DNB sample from our friend and that needs there to make her sing into the next break, then that's what we have to do. I guess if that answers.
So the album Subway Anthem comes out on September 29th, but what's next for ATENA after that, mate? You got any shows planned?
Yeah, we're working on shows for next year. Like when we speak now, we've been playing some Norwegian dates again. It's been a year since last time. Had a blast doing those, and now we're just looking out on doing European shows next year. Like we were all obviously afflicted by the 2-3 year gap that happened. Had shows pushed around, etc. So just trying to get back into to that, just playing Europe again. We did some shows last summer who had been booked originally for 2020, but we want to get out there again. That's kind of the plan.
Before we let you go, mate, we've started up three new Spotify playlists based on artists that we speak to. So, using your own songs, so using a ten of songs, give us a song for a playlist to get the party started, a song for a playlist to save your marriage, and a song for a playlist that could potentially end your marriage.
Oh wow. Does it have to be from the new album
Not from any album,
or?
any of your music.
Okay, so to end your marriage, there's a song called Cheater off of a album from 2017. Not written by me lyrically, but I'm sure that will sour the tone in the room if you present it as your view. What was the other categories
Save your
again?
marriage.
Then, we have a song in Norwegian, which would make it usually makes people cry and hug, but I guess it doesn't apply here in this English context. So maybe Oh My, because it's so delicate and full of falsetto and makes you think of the fragile things in life, and it has nice melodies and stuff. Yeah, I'll say that. Yeah,
And
Oh My from the new album.
what to get the party started?
This is gonna sound weird without being this, but Domestic Abuse. It's a really nice dance song from a previous record. So either Domestic Abuse or Subway Anthem from the new album.
Beautiful. All right, mate. Well,
Yeah,
thanks very much.
nice question, by the way.
And no worries at all, brother. Thanks very much for your time. I know it's early over there, mate, so I hope we can set you up for a good day. But Subway Anthem
Yeah.
out on September 29th. So best of luck with it, bro.
killers too.